afternoon, we have here the very honourable Dr. Harjit Singh of the Johor Cricket Council. Hi, Dr. Harjit.
Hello.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
And I'd just like to know, what are your thoughts about the Johor cricket scene? How's it coming along?
Well, see, we have focused mainly on development. And that has been our key interest. We've been mainly focusing on primary schools. We were the first state in the country to start a primary school cricket tournament, as well as in the first year in 1987, we only had 17 schools in the state playing cricket at under 12th level. Today we have got about 200 odd schools. And every district in the state of Johor plays cricket. So we have an under 11 inter-district tournament, we have under 16th and under 18th inter-district tournament. Our main focus has always been on development, because development simply means, in my vocabulary, development simply means two words: creating opportunity. So what we did was we provided equipment to the schools. We got hold of all the teachers from the schools to come for elementary courses and then form their teams and back in the schools and meet the tournament. And when I was deputy president of Malaysian Cricket in 1992, we introduced the first ever 112 inter-school tournament. And that is still going on until today. And, the main reason why we have to focus on juniors first rather than thinking of the elite and winning championships is we have to first of all create player teams.
Yeah.
It's actually the tripartite elements that lead to development. First thing is player keenness. Once you develop the player keenness, you then go for media interest. When the media finds that you're doing something,
that's bigger.
Yes. Becomes a bigger picture. And when sponsors find that you are doing something good and the media sort of promotes you, then sponsorship will come. And that is one aspect of the administrative aspect of development. Now, when it comes to the foundation of development, again, the first thing is player fitness. Number two, we have to broaden the base. And that has been our key focus. We spread it out to as many schools as possible. And we have the largest number of secondary schools in any state playing cricket. Yeah. And so the first thing is player fitness, second is broadening the base. Then you select the best and you improve the standards. So these are the three criteria from the foundational aspect of development and administrative aspect of it is player keenness, media interest, sponsorship. So when you can get all these complemented into each other, then you are quite successful in
development.
And we started off in 1987 and it took us 10 years to find a ground for cricket called its own. And this is where you are today. And we kept on pestering state government and through His Majesty, the great Sultan of Johor, and then he was out. We managed to secure this 14.25 acres of land, and we built what is today the first cricket academy in Southeast Asia. And so within the next 8 years, we were able to set up the first indoor cricket ball in Southeast Asia. Now we have a very good working relationship with Singapore Cricket, and which I would say that it is very much complemented by our close cultural and friendly ties between Johor and Singapore. And apart from that, our close relationship with Singapore Cricket Association. And we always put out of the boundaries. Cricket has got no boundaries. Sport has no boundaries. So we go beyond the boundary of political divide and expand the game and complement each other's development. So I always welcome Singapore over here, and we have hosted a lot of their tournaments, the Solar Cup, Stanley Cup for them. Whenever they do not have the grounds ready, I mean the grounds are fully occupied.
So thankful.
We have worked together,
yeah.
And today we are working together in terms of development. I always look forward to that, and I hope that this will be something that will be cherished for the future as well.
Definitely. So, a lot of development talk is going on. So, any plans to further develop the facility itself?
Oh yes, we are working together with Singapore to develop. See, we at the moment, we getting these boys coming in for training on weekends. And we convert our changing rooms, the three changing rooms, into dormitories. So now we are working to build our own hostel and, with an in-house kitchen and dining hall, as well as some rooms for officials to stay, so that we can always have training programs throughout the year without the main building being affected. And that's why, I mean, matches can go on in the field, but development can go on in the indoor hall, as well as the accommodation will be separate. That will be one entity by itself. And we also want to put up more nets to develop this place, and at the same time maybe an indoor hall with an open concept. With grass wickets covered, I mean, all grass wickets, so that in case there is rain, you are still able to play in that hall on natural
turf
wickets. So we are working together with Singapore Cricket Association of that, and working. See, the utility here is not so much, so it would be good if we can combine with the Singapore Cricket Association and clubs from Singapore to come over and use our facility. And of course, the inside is more than good.
Of course, when he has to come
to
the picture, then we can go on. That's wonderful, Dr. Harjit. I mean, having a home here, a hostel here, would make everyone feel more welcome. And when they tie, they can just retire for a while and constantly doing their best. Well, thank you so much for having us today, Dr. Harjit.
Thank you.
It's been a great pleasure.